Hi, this is lurppis from winout.net, and I'm here to show you how to properly run and execute B-Split on DustTube. Now, obviously, you can just run it quick with one guy going tunnels with a bomb and four guys running out mid with smokes and a couple of flashes, but if you want to make yourself less vulnerable to random stuff like one CT spraying down multiple people or opera getting picks and stuff like that, and just make it less risky all around, you may want to take it much slower. So first of all, if you have a set up around the team, your best bet is having that guy carry the bomb and come from the B tunnels when the four others are going mid. But since he's in no hurry in the beginning of the round, he should always hold this angle to see if anyone's going to lower B tunnels. So the three guys there can be ready for that. Now the fifth guy is going to be up around this area. He may want to try to make some sounds like spam there or something like that to try to get a read on what the CTs are doing. See if they're pushed up a long or cat, and then he can just wait over here and stay ready for the three guys in lower B to call for the flashers. So when you're going through the tunnels, it's a good idea to try to replicate the sounds that you would normally do on any other round instead of just being completely silent when on all the other rounds you're making a lot of noise. So you have three guys going through here. Just always walk, then just boost on. It's a good idea to boost on top of this box. You can see if there's the M4 or Alper pushed up behind that box, and you can see that there's no one here. Then while you're up here and you have two guys waiting behind the box making sure no one boosted up on Cat can see them, you call the guy up middle for a flash. Now he's gonna flash right over there. We're just gonna blind any CTs pushed up on catwalk area and make it easy for the three guys over here to nade Cat, then spam the double doors, make sure there's no one pushed up, and take over the middle area. Now once three guys are here, first guy should set up for that flash, which is going right over there, and it's gonna blind anybody around the green box, the window, or by the B door. So when three guys down middle are lined up there and ready to go, the guy up here is gonna flash over there. It's gonna explode almost directly after the door. So if anyone's around the CT spawn area over here or around here or anywhere in the general middle area, you're gonna be blind for sure. There's nowhere you're gonna dodge that. So now you have three guys going up middle. First guy should always just go out with his gun in case there's a CT that's semi-blind there. Three guys going up middle, flashing over B doors. You're definitely gonna be able to take over B relatively easily, probably looking at maximum losing one guy. Now the only thing you can really do wrong here is have the air coming B too early. There's no reason for him to go in before the three guys have totally cleared up B side, unless they're getting shot down in the middle. So you take over B with three guys, you lose one, maybe two if you're really unlucky, and you're gonna get the plant here. You're gonna be in great position in like a 3v3 to win the round, but you still have fifth guy. You'll have the fifth guy right here in the terrorist middle area. So he has three things he can do here. Now either he can just jump to lower B tunnels and run towards B and be there in a good position for the CT's retake. He can stay here, terrorist middle area, try to get a peek on double doors and then do the same. Or what I the best thing to do, unless there's like tops one guy left, and especially if you hear CT's pushed up along, you're gonna know catwalk is clear, so you can just crouch up all the way around here. Now when you hear CT's going through spawn, you can just jump down here, and you're always gonna be getting 2 to 3 kills in the back, totally free kills. So even if you're down to like a 2v4 situation and you flank there, you still have a real good shot at winning the round. so that was lurppis from the former gameplay team for winout.net showing you how to do a B-split on Dust2.